vibration is still amongst it. What do you see? Like I showed y'all that picture last night, right? The bouquet of flowers, but it didn't look like a bouquet of flowers. It was about the light, the candles, everything was about rain. Popular festival during the Middle Ages, held on or about January 1st, particularly in France, in which a mock bishop or pope was elected, ecclesiastical rituals was parried, and low and high officials changed places. Such festivals were probably a Christian adoption, adaptation of the pagan festivities of Saturnalia. By the 13th century, these feasts had become a burlesque of Christian morality and worship.
I forgive what you mean. Maybe it's like a revealing skin and
like lace.
Like a sexual.
Yeah.
Nudity.
I read somewhere also where, because during that time, like during that celebration, it was like a week. They pretty much was able to live lawless,
How
they do on the purge. You just live lawless, man. You could go out and drink as much as you want, eat as much as you want. You could go around butt ass naked. You could do all that shit. That's what they were doing.
Okay.
It was all right. Wilding out.
Yeah, it was like you said a week.
Yeah. Same as coming to Sin City.
Yeah.
You can do whatever you can do.
And you think about it. That week starts now and ends on New Year's.
Yep.
It's doing the same shit.
Yep. That's how they set it up.
Mm-hmm.
To where you blend up the shit into the pagan worship. You see that word? You see that word? Sigla, whatever that word was?
I didn't see
it. Up. It just showed a tree.
About a tree?
It's Isaiah 44 and 9. It says, they that make a graven image, all of they that make a graven image are all of them vanish.
Now, you're telling me Christians have a graven image? It's so deep in the people's minds, graven into the people's minds, as soon as a newborn of the family comes to life, right? Or comes out, they gotta get them in it immediately. They can't wait for a baby's first Christmas. They'll go get in prison, a few days after a month or whatever after you're born, and then they'll take him right now and come December, pretty much sacrifice him.
It says, and their delectable things shall not profit, and they are their own witness. They shall not nor know that they shall make that they may be ashamed. Who hath formed a power or molded a graven image that is profitable for nothing? Behold, all his fellows shall be ashamed, and the workmen, they are of men. Let them all be gathered together, let them stand up. Yet they shall fear, and they shall be ashamed together. The smith with the tongs both worketh in the gold, and fashioneth it with hammers, and worketh it with the strength of his arms. Yea, he is hungry, and his strength faileth, drinketh no water, and is faint. The carpenter stretcheth out his rule, he maketh it out with the line, he fitteth it with the planes, and he marketh it out with the compass and maketh it after the figure of a man.
I noticed the woman that is
into the dark.
Maketh it after the figure of a man according to the beauty of a man, that it may remain in the house. He heweth down cedars, and taketh the cypress and the oak, which he strengtheneth for himself among the trees of the forest. Planted in ash and rain does nourish it. Right, basically going into all the different ways that these idols are formed. You have the smith, which is created out of wood. out of precious metals. Yeah. You got the carpenter fastening with whatever tool he's using. But it says hewed down cedars and taking the cypress and oak, which he strengthened it for himself among the trees of the forest. He planteth in ash and rain doth nourish it. Then shall it be for a man to burn, for he will take thereof and warm himself. Yea, he kindleth it and break and maketh bread. Yea, he maketh a god and worshipeth it. He maketh it a graven image and falleth down to it. He burneth to it. Yep. He burneth part thereof in the fire, with part thereof he eateth flesh. He roasteth roast and is satisfied. In the same custom that Jacob learned to be. Yea, he warmeth himself and say, aha, I am warm, I have seen the fire. And the residue thereof he maketh it a god, even his graven image.
Now, what if they just take the same preparation,
bro?
With
give
that
the
type
glory
of
to Yahweh.
Right. We'd rather give it to these guys.
Continue. It says, he boiled down until...
So the Lord's name is polluted amongst the heathen. They take, they ascribe the glory of the Most High and give it to an idol. They're pretty much profaning his name. They're defiling his name, because the Lord placed his name upon Israel. So the Lord placed his name upon Israel, and Israel is given the glory, they're ascribing the glory to idols. That's basically what they're doing. They're profaning his name, man. This is what pissed the Heavenly Father off. You know? I created the man who created that. You want to worship that? Are you serious? I can see the heathens doing that shit because they're vain. Mm-hmm. But you? What the fuck is wrong with you? You know?
It says, he falleth down unto it and worshipeth it and prayeth unto it and saith, deliver me, for thou art my God. They have not known nor understood. For he hath shut their eyes that they cannot see, and their hearts that they cannot understand. And none considereth in his heart, in his mind, neither is there knowledge nor understanding to say, I have burnt part of it in the fire, and also I have baked bread upon the coals thereof, I have roasted flesh and meat, and shall I make the residue thereof an abomination? Shall I fall down to the stock of a tree? He eateth of ashes and deceived earth. I turned him aside, and he cannot deliver his soul, nor say, is there not a God in my right hand? Remember these, O Jacob and Israel, for thou art my servant. I have formed thee, thou art my servant, O Israel. Thou shalt not be forgotten of me. Yeah, that's cool. Oh, it's like I keep going. I have blotted out as a thick cloud thy transgression, and as for a cloud thy sins, and that's for the elect. Return unto me, for I have redeemed thee. Sing, O ye heavens, for the Lord Yahweh hath done it. Shout, ye lower parts of the earth. Break forth into singing, ye mountains. O forest and every tree therein. For the Lord Yahweh, by Hashem Yahweh Shai, hath redeemed Jacob, and glorified himself in Israel.
Real quick, and this is, segueing back into Saturnalia, right? This is 1 Corinthians 10 and 20. This is NLT. This is Apostle Paul. It says, I'll start at 19. It says, what am I trying to say? Am I saying that offered to idols has some significance? Or that idols are real gods? No, not at all. I'm saying that these sacrifices are offered to demons, not to the Most High. And I don't want you to participate with demons. This is why we tell you, don't participate in this. We don't want our children participating in it, you know? Don't participate in this. You participate in the demonic festivity, okay? This is why a lot of death happens during this time, okay? It says, you cannot drink from the cup of the Lord and from the cup of demons too. You cannot eat at the Lord's table and at the table of demons too. What do we de- Do we dare to rouse the Lord's jealousy? Do you think we are stronger than he is? Hell no, we ain't. Alright? But that's what you're doing. You're partaking in demonic festivities, so you're pretty much fellowshipping with demons. Scriptures say to be not unequally yoked together with unbelievers. What fellowship do righteous have with unrighteousness? You know? What fellowship do light have with darkness? You know, that's why he said to be separate. Come out from among them and touch not the unclean thing, and I will receive you.
First chapter of Sirach, fear the Lord. You know, fear the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. You know, our people don't fear the Lord. That's why when judgment come upon them, and they don't think the Lord got it. You know, even though they said, oh God, you. I'm not thinking about the sins they commit to the Heavenly Father. And so,
Micah chapter 2, verse 10, the mind is the part, for this is not your rest, because it is polluted, and shall destroy you even with the sword is punished. The punishment for being involved in this.
What though? I don't know.
That's pollution.
That's profane.
Yeah.
Habakkuk, the second chapter, 18th verse. What profiteth the graven image to the maker thereof as graven? The molten image and the teacher of lies that the maker of his work trusteth therein to make dumb idols. Woe unto him that saith to the wood, awake, to the dumb stone, arise, it shall teach. Behold, it is laid over with gold and silver, and there was no breath at all in the midst of it.
Hey, isn't that cobblestone the same thing? Like, it is like a wooden structure overlaid with semi-precious stone or something like that, but on the inside, like a moon rock or some shit that they say.
Yeah, rock itself.
People just look for anything to worship. You actually have a living being. You actually have a living power that requires you to worship and gives you how to do it in an instruction manual on how to reverence it called the Bible.
You know, people want to see you. They want to see you, feel, and touch. They just can't have faith.
Is Jeremiah 2? I'll start the top down there. It's Jeremiah 2 at the top. But I know. I'll start the top. Jeremiah 2 at the top. Moreover, the word of the Lord came to me, saying, go and cry in the ears of Jerusalem, saying, thus saith the Lord, I remember thee, the kindness of thy youth, the love of thine espousals when thou wentest after me in the wilderness in a man that was not sown. Israel was holiness unto the Lord in the first fruits of his increase.
That's why the Lord sent out the prophet. Every prophet, you know, that the Lord woke up and sent out, is cussing out you Israelites, serving idols. Serving these dumbass idols, man, that you create from your mind, you know?
It says, hear ye the words, and the first fruits of his increase, all that devour him shall offend, evil shall come upon them, says the Lord. Hear ye the word of the Lord.
Evil shall come upon them. Hey, they feeling that evil over there, you know, down south in the East Coast. They feeling it.
Hear ye the word of the Lord, Yahweh, O house of Jacob, and all the families of the house of Israel.
That's all Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans. They're the house of Israel.
Thus saith the Lord, what iniquity have your fathers found in me, that they are gone far from me?